Migraine is a complex neurological disease that can impact the entire nervous system. The diagnostic criteria for migraine is the following. Patients must have had at least 5 headache attacks that lasted 4 to 72 hours, and the headache should have had at least 2 of the following characteristics. One-sided head pain, pulsating sensation, moderate or severe pain intensity, aggravation by physical activity. In addition, during the headaches, the patient must have had nausea and/or vomiting or light and sound sensitivity. Many other symptoms can also be associated with migraine attacks, such as confused thinking, ear pain, dizziness, and more. It is important to note, these are the strict criteria, but variations are possible. Therefore, you should talk to your doctor for a correct diagnosis based on your history. People with migraine can have an episodic or chronic form of the disease. Let's explore the differences. Most people start with episodic migraine, which is less than 15 headache days per month. People with chronic migraine have at least 15 headache days per month, with light and sound sensitivity, nausea, or vomiting for at least 8 of those days. Between 4 and 6 million Americans live with chronic migraine. Why does the difference matter? The frequency of attacks is important to help determine appropriate treatments and to understand how disabling the disease is for a person. Chronic migraine usually represents a more severe form of the disease. People with chronic migraine have a disease that has become more difficult to treat, are at risk of excessive use of pain relievers, and at risk for medication adaptation headache, should be considered a candidate for preventative drugs. About 2 to 3% of patients with episodic migraine develop chronic migraine every year. Reasons for this include lack of proper treatment and changes in triggers such as hormones or lifestyle changes. Can you treat migraine? Yes. Medications that can be taken on the onset of an attack include over-the-counter options like acetaminophen, ibuprofen, or non-steroidal medications in combination with caffeine or prescription options like triptans, diethans, and gepants. Avoid using these medications more than 1 to 2 days per week on a consistent basis, as they can put you at risk for medication resistance and contribute to migraine chronification. Neuromodulation devices can be used as an additional therapy or used in replacement of pharmaceuticals. If you are using abortive treatments more than 9 times per month, you and your doctor should consider a preventative treatment. Some treatments can be used to prevent attacks, including onabotulinum toxin A, blood pressure medications, anti-seizure medications, antidepressants, and more recently, CGRP monoclonal antibodies and some gepants have been approved for the preventative treatment of migraine. Learn more at migrainedisorders.org.